Look at you. You did it. You're still here. Despite everything you've been through. Here you are. I'd imagine you've been told many things leading up to this point. So I will simply say thank you for the honor and privilege of being able to watch you grow into the adventurer you've always wanted to be. I'm proud of you.
And here it is, our final night alive, as the earth burns to the ground. Oh girl, it's you!
You don't need coffee.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yeah.
Oh, you like pain?
Mm-hmm.
All right, tonight I'm gonna make it hurt.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah, you know what we're gonna do?
What are you gonna do to me?
You wanna know?
Yeah.
You really wanna know?
Oh, yeah.
We're gonna confront that trauma and start the healing process.
Oh, yeah. No.
It's actually not that serious. I just need you to stay calm, okay?
Yeah, I'm just gonna stay angry. I find that relaxes me.
This time we debunk the myth. Myth remains bunked.
Even the doorknob smells like her. Why are you smelling the doorknob?
Hi, I'm Johnny Knoxville. Welcome to Jackass.
I'm a super mom, kid, bitch, I'm a mother! No drama!
Poster reveals a smile from the back. Elephants and acrobats, lions, snakes, monkey. Village speaks righteous, sister Cena says funky. How bizarre! How bizarre! How bizarre!
Bullying, knock it off. Racism, knock it off. Bigotry, knock it off. Crime, knock it off. Robin Banks, knock it off. Not saying thanks, knock it off.
My dad's condom broke in 97. Now I exist so I can pay bills and have crippling depression. They said congrats on being born. Now get a job, you lazy capitalist whore.
And what did my little girl want?
An absence of mood swings and some stability in my life.
How about a pony?
Okay.
The NCR has declared you a terrorist. Wherever the NCR has jurisdiction, you'll be shot on sight.
It's about fucking time, fellas.
And I don't want the world to see me.
Cause I don't think that they'd understand. When everything's made to be broken, I just want...
How to make D&D monsters 10 times scarier using real-life facts. Today we're going to focus on the giant spider, a creature that doesn't really need to get any scarier, but we're going to do it anyway. In real life, many spiders actually have the ability to shoot out harpoon-shaped hairs tipped with stinging barbs at their enemies. And if throwing a bunch of harpoon-like hairs at your party isn't bad enough, the spiders can just throw themselves. That's because some spiders can actually use their webs like slingshots and launch themselves at their prey, getting up to speeds of about 1700 miles per hour. There's also this thing called spider rain, where a bunch of spiders will actually use their webs as balloons and fall from the sky, which all makes the giant spider a pretty terrifying creature to use in your next encounter.
Listen to me now.
Zooby zooby zoo.
Nobody needs to know.
Butterfly in the sky, I can go twice as high. Take a look, it's in a book, a reading rainbow.
All right, I am headed off to that little boutique store that doesn't have any security cameras, so I will see y'all later. Have fun. Hey, is that my jacket? What? No, this is mine. I just bought this at the thrift store. Well, it looks exactly like my jacket that's been missing all week, and it has my initials on it. Yeah, I liked yours so much that I had this custom made to look identical. You just said you bought it at a thrift store. Never said that, but hey, since you lost yours, you can totally borrow mine. Just let me borrow, like, $20 in return. That is so sweet, and yeah, that's totally fair. That's weird. I had, like, a bunch of cash in here. Wow, that is super weird. How about I'll take an IOU for the cash, and you just let me borrow your truck today? Thank you for being so understanding. Yeah, have fun with the truck. She's so nice, right? This whole interaction made me dumber. Oh, sorry, this whole table's actually reserved. I'm doing a little intro to D&D night, but there's some open tables. Oh, you're here for that. They invited you. No, sorry, you just don't really seem like someone who'd be into D&D, you know? Yeah, it's a little bit more than pixies and dragons and unicorns. It's actually, oh, you're into high fantasy. Let me guess, you've seen Lord of the Rings once. You've read those? Yeah, well, take a seat. It's just gonna be really hard for you to follow along since you kinda need the player's handbook to... And you have that. You know, it's totally fine. I will just explain it to you like I explained it to my 8-year-old nephew. Also, there's like a lot of math involved, so if you get confused and wanna leave and never come back, it's totally fine. No hard feelings.
This filter shows you your D and D class.
What? A bugbear? Bugbear's not even a class. What the hell?
I don't look like a damn bugbear. What? No.
out the house with my swagger. Hop in that window, I got places to go. People to see, time is precious. I look at my Cartier out of control. Just like my mind, where I'm going, I'm winning. The shorties know nothing but clothes. I'm putting on my Pirelli's on. I like my Jimmy, that's all it's on. The storm is coming, my pockets keep telling me it's gonna shower. Call up my homies, it's on, they're popping the night, it's a bit of the hours. We keep a fadeaway shot, cause we ballin', it's got the Patron, it be our. Look on my owl, you just like the flowers. Look at the truth, you're all like the flowers.
This filter is actually not an attractiveness scale. It's a tool that DMs use to see what challenge rating monster they should throw at their party.
Fear me.
Alright, I'm gonna pick another creature from the monster manual, and you have to guess which one based on my descriptions. Let's go. As you open the door to the evil wizard's study, the first thing that you notice is the smell. Putrid and sour, like rotten meat. As you go to plug your nose, you notice a flash of movement out of the corner of your eye. You turn, just in time, to see a small creature skitter across the floor. Its form is that of a spider's, but missing a few legs. Three, to be exact. What is it?
Right, no matter what this gives us, let's see if we can make a character out of it. We got a halfling rogue with really bad dex. This one's not too bad. We have decent strength, so I feel like we should go strength-based rogue. And we also got pretty good intelligence, so we can definitely hit up Arcane Trickster, while also using a lot of spells to cover up the fact that we're really not that stealthy. Not too bad, I like it.